Nasugbu is no stranger to all things big. It is one of the largest municipalities in Batangas in terms of land area, population, and history. But there's one more thing that it can boast. It is also big on natural wonders. Nasugbu's town center is set in an agricultural plain, but much of the municipality's terrain is crumpled with mountains, concealing dozens of pristine coves at their feet. Hey there, poor traveler! We are Vince and Josh, and in this video, we're sharing with you some of the best things to do and places to visit in Nasugbu, Batangas. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so you get notified when we upload new travel videos. Fortune Island. Fortune Island used to be a private property harboring an exclusive luxury resort. But it is difficult and costly to maintain a luxury resort without a ready source of fresh water. It ceased operations in 2006. One remarkable reminder of its grandeur stands atop the island's limestone cliff overlooking the sea, Grecian pillars, and statues. Fortune Island is generally rocky with a short stretch of sand. It is now popular among campers and sun worshippers, but it was for the longest time a best-kept secret among divers. The island is surrounded by shipwrecked diving sites including the Dutch warship Mauritius, which sank in December 1600. Calayo Beach. Calayo Beach is a public beach lined with several houses and budget to mid-range resorts. The sand here is closer to light brown than white, but it is a jump-off point to better beaches like Pulo-Pulo, Kerang Cove, and Between Cove, which are probably the main reasons why you would be visiting Calayo in the first place. If you need to use facilities like restrooms and tables or even swimming pools, you can stay at the resort as a day tripper. For example, Calayo Green Terraces allows day tours for a fee. Pulo-Pulo. Locals call it Pulo-Pulo, but tourists know this as Pulo Island or Loren Island. It's located just 20 minutes from Calayo Beach. The sand here isn't white or fine either. It's beige and pebbly at best, but still offers a fantastic island escape. The island has two beaches and what looks like a sandbar that links to another rocky islet. There is a small entrance fee. Between Cove. Sometimes called locally as Angara Cove, is a privately owned property but people can still access it for a minimal fee. This short strip of sand and shingles is a rising camping destination just 20 minutes away from Calayo Beach. The sand is not white nor is it fine, but the underwater scene is never lacking. There's a man-made breakwater, the remnants of what used to be a helipad, and a rundown dock or diving platform. Apart from one or two small stalls, an open cottage, a rusty container van, and a simple white rest house, there's nothing for lodging but the ground to pitch your tent. This is slowly becoming popular among those who like the outdoors and roughing it out by camping. You can stay overnight or visit as part of an island hopping tour. Here are the rates when we visited. Kerang Cove. Also in Barangay Calayo, this pristine stretch is testament to the natural resources that Nasugbu possesses. When we visited, boatmen are no longer allowed to dock or moor their boats on the beach, but they can still take passengers to the cove provided that they stay in the water. It's no problem because the water here is so shallow. This is one of our favorite spots in Nasugbu. Not many people know about this and it's not usually part of island hopping tours. So we had the place to ourselves during our visit. Although we didn't get to set foot on the beach, we still enjoyed a quiet, relaxing alone time in the water. Caleruega Chapel. The place got its name from the municipality of Caleruega in Spain, the birthplace of the father of the Order of the Preachers, Saint Dominic de Guzman. It was built to serve as a venue for contemplation, but because it is so picturesque, it has made a name for itself over the years as one of the most well-known retreat or wedding venues in the country, especially among those from Manila. Perched on top of a garden-adorned hill, it offers a spectacular view of the Batangan countryside with Mount Batolao dominating the landscape. Getting to Caleruega is not too complicated. Whether you go there by public transportation or by private car, you will travel along the Tagaytay-Nasugbu Highway coming from Manila. The jump-off point to the chapel is the Casey Hillcrest Golf Course. Mount Batolao. Mount Batolao is one of the most recommended mountains to hike for beginners. I haven't tried climbing this, but our partner and teammate Asta has done it a few times. According to her, it's not too steep and not too high, which makes it relatively easy for the experience, but can still be exciting and challenging for budding adventurers. One thing is for sure though, this is one heck of a postcard-worthy peak that allows a view that you have to see for yourself. Tali Beach. One of the most well-known attractions in Nasugbu, this beach has long been a summer favorite in Batangas. Aside from the beach, one can also enjoy its cliff jumping spot. However, because it's part of a private subdivision, access to it is restricted only to residents, homeowners, and their guests. You must know someone inside to get in. It's easy to find a way though. You can simply rent a house for a night. There's also a travel agency that takes visitors on a day tour to the beach. The streets of Nasugbu Town proper is flanked with corinderias or low-cost eateries and fast food options. So, it's not hard at all to find a cheap but filling meal. But if you want to try a place that you can only experience in Nasugbu, we recommend these two. Kainan sa Dalampasigan. First of all, there is no view of the sea. Just getting it out there this early because the name of the place sort of implies that. But despite that, Kainan sa Dalampasigan is still a delightful seafood restaurant. This authentic Batangueño gastronomic spot is concealed in a lush garden that allows visitors a quick but memorable moment with nature. It's an oasis in the middle of a rapidly developing town. It's best known for their Bilao sa Dalampasigan, which is a platter of four of their best sellers, baked tahong or mussels, garlic shrimps, daing na bangus or milkfish, and grilled pork. The first time I was here, an order cost 550 pesos. Now it's almost 1,000. If the serving size or the price is too steep for you, I recommend going for the baked mussels alone. It's definitely the best among the quartet. El Cocinero by Chef Arnaldo. This wasn't part of our original itinerary. We were on the way home when we passed by this place and decided to give it a try. From the outside, it doesn't look much, but this unassuming restaurant has that proverbial inner beauty. It feels so homey inside, and every corner is IG worthy. The menu is predominantly Spanish. The best seller, its signature El Cocinero Paella, which is a pan full of flavorful risotto topped with chicken, chorizo, mushrooms, fish, crabs, shrimps, squid, and mussels. It can feed up to 4 hungry travelers. It's a bit pricey though. La Locanda Pizzeria Ristorante. La Locanda Pizzeria Ristorante has an extensive menu with over 100 items, which can be quite overwhelming. In true Italian fashion, the servings here are pretty big, so even the single orders can still be good for sharing. We didn't know this at first and we were a big group, so we ended up with over a dozen different dishes. But what stood out was their spaghetti alla carbonara, which is cooked in authentic traditional Italian style using eggs instead of cream, and spaghetti al cartoccio, which is pasta and seafood baked in foil. Among their pizzas, the ones that stood out were their pizza Bismarck with sunny side up eggs and thick cuts of prosciutto, and pizza Giada with shrimps, fresh tomatoes, arugula, and 3 types of cheeses. Nasugbu Church. Nasugbu's parish church may not be as popular as Calaruega or other central churches in other Batangan municipalities, but it can still be worth a visit, especially for devout Catholics. Officially called St. Francis Xavier Parish Church, it's also dedicated to Nuestra Señora Virgen de la Escalera. Its original form was a wooden church built in the early 1850s, but it burned down. What stands today is the reconstruction done in the 1990s. If you need more information about traveling around Nasugbu or other parts of Batangas, you'll find several comprehensive travel guides on our website, www.theportraveler.net,
or check out the links in the description.
If you have questions, make good use of the comment section below. You can also find us on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, and Twitter. Just look for @ThePoorTraveler, single L. You may also follow and tune in to The Poor Traveler podcast on Spotify. That's all for now. Remember, plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.